tenemos que respetar la naturaleza. El agua es sagrado porque viene del cielo, baja a la tierra y penetra las montañas y vuelve a salir por el mar y vuelve a subir y así nos da la vida. El ciclo natural para nosotros es sagrado. And this is the cycle, the sacred cycle of the water. We cannot interrupt this cycle.
There's no alternative to water. None. And that's the key issue here. Survival.
Criminals! You guys are criminals! Go get your money somewhere else!
The oil pipeline company, Energy Transfer Partners, resumes their digging in defiance of a pending court decision which would protect the Lakota Cemetery grounds and sacred sites. The sound of the bulldozers brings out the nearby Standing Rock community in force. Security police unleash their attack dogs and pepper spray against the water protectors.
Yeah, we know that dog. Know him very well. A conquistador. They hunted our people. Same way. And so here we are, some 450 years later, and nothing seems to have changed.
Look at this. The dog did it, you know? Look at this.
By the end of the nonviolent protest, 30 water protectors are immobilized by pepper spray, and 6 are reportedly bitten by the private security dogs.
No one owns this land. This land belongs to the earth. We are only caretakers. We're caretakers of the earth.
We are not bleeding. We are not bleeding.
So when you grow up with the idea that there's always a better place, always another place, and this place here suffers the consequence of that kind of thinking. And now, not only this place, but everybody, all humanity, suffered the consequence of that thinking today. Now we're facing a reality and the consequence of our disregarding the laws of the earth.
Entonces, la sabiduría que nosotros tenemos es, tiene una base, no es solamente una base filosófica de, que viene de la naturaleza, que viene del medio ambiente. Esta fuerza podemos encontrar en los vientos, en la lluvia, en las piedras, en los ríos, los montes. Eso no es una cosa solamente de conservación, preservación, pero de utilizar esa sabiduría, que aquí podemos llamar de ciencia, para mejorar la vida de todos.